I'm sure a lot of you people missed this because YouTube censorship. But this is Pauline Hanson, and she's one of our ministers for One Nation. She has, basically single-handedly, I mean, she's been on about it for many, many years, created a change to our family law, a reform. Anyway, I think I'm probably going to do a misjustice by talking about it, so I'm going to let her speak for herself. This was her raising of the bill and her her acceptance of the bill at Parliament House. Here we go.
Over the past year, it's been an immense privilege to be in the role of Deputy Chair of the Joint Select Committee on Australia's Family Law System. The work of the committee has revealed what many of us know, that the proceedings, structure and systems of the family court profoundly impact more Australians than any other part of our legal system, and too often that impact has devastating effects. I first brought up many of these issues and problems in and around the family court back in 1996, and I have never wavered in my belief that the family court requires far-reaching and a thorough overhaul if it is to properly serve the millions of Australians who come under its influence. This bill and the changes recommended are close to my heart, and I speak with the benefit of first-hand knowledge. I have personally experienced and survived the family court as a wife, then as a mother, and later as a grandmother. And yes, I have experienced domestic violence. I have described the scope of these impacts previously in this place, and I can think of no better way to focus our minds on the human motivation for this bill than to quote my words from Hansard. The family law system has been and continues to be plagued by deep emotions, sadness, financial hardship, and bankruptcies, long-term psychological damage, abuse, stress, suicides, and in some cases, murder. And I paraphrase here, including the murder of children by both male and female parents and extended family members. Unfortunately, there are those in the community who thrive on the pain of those going through separation and the courts, lawyers who charge exorbitant fees to the point of bankrupting clients, feminists who relish the toxic anti-men rhetoric, and jaded partners who will stop at nothing to use their separation and the court system to crush their rivals, including unfounded claims of domestic violence. Unfortunately, they are also harming their children in the process. Put simply, we need to revamp the system to make it better for everyone involved. The family court is in an unusual position of being a rigged, formalised judicial body that is tasked with overseeing challenges that are human, all unique, emotional, and characterised by vulnerability. And as I've said previously, a one-size-fits-all approach in this arena will always fail. End quote. Participation in the family court system, whether willingly or when a person is dragged in and compelled to defend allegations, has taken an all too often terrible toll on potentially millions of people in this country. This bill is the product of a series of reviews that began when the Simple Review in 2008. The Simple Review produced a report titled Future Governance Options for Federal Family Law Courts in Australia. This report found, and I quote, "There exists a significant level of duplication of administrative structures and corporate services across the Family Court and the Federal Circuit Court," end quote. The report found that the structure and costs were not financially sustainable. It also found the structure took up resources that could have been used more effectively to assist people appearing before the court. The 2012 Skehill Review looked at a number of options for action designed to improve the efficiency and effectiveness of court administration. The 2014 KPMG review found the current funding model for the courts was not sustainable, and simply throwing money at the problem was not a solution. In 2018, yet another review, the PwC review, looked at the operations of the courts in relation to family law matters. Which brings us to 2019, when the Australian Law Reform Commission review, commissioned by then Attorney General Brandis, handed down its report. And if, following court after report and review after review, you didn't already think there was reason enough to be here today, just listen to the Commission's report, which said the family law system has been, and I quote, deprived of resources to such an extent that it cannot deliver the quality of justice expected of a country like Australia. There is a chronic lack of funding for the appointment and proper training of judicial resources, court-based social services professionals, including family consultants and Indigenous liaison officers, and legal aid services, including independent children's lawyers. As a consequence, children and families are deprived of sufficient time and attention being given to the matter at all stages of the process, with the obvious risks that this entails, end quote. So a decade of reports and reviews confirm time after time the system, the structure, and the funding of the courts in this most critical of areas were all wrong and proved that tinkering at the edges left a trail of devastated families in its wake. At the time of its interim report last October, the Joint Select Committee, on which I serve as Deputy Chair, has received more than 1,500 individual submissions, as well as 169 submissions from organisations, academics and other professionals, all of which brings us to today and the bill before us. We are told by the Attorney General that the structural reforms contained within the bill will help Australian families resolve their disputes faster, provide appropriate protection for vulnerable people, and ensure suitability, qualified and experienced professionals are available to support families in need. I also note that the proposed structural reform of the federal courts is intended to create a consistent pathway for Australian families in having their family law disputes dealt with in the federal courts, improve the efficiency of the federal court system, and ensure outcomes for Australian families are resolved in the most timely, informed, and cost-effective manner possible. We are told also the long overdue structural reform has the potential to allow an extra 8,000 cases to be resolved each year. That's 8,000 cases. Just last year, we had an extra 45,000 cases come before the Federal Circuit Court. That will resolve an extra 8,000 a year, which no doubt will reduce the significant frustration felt by so many families. There has been criticism of the bill from some legal quarters that does not surprise me. I believe it's fair to say that being appointed a judge of the Family Court of Australia has, until now, been regarded as a golden ticket within the legal profession. Any alteration to the current system will probably upset the long-term retirement and pension plans of some in the profession, and I don't doubt that's where a lot of the squealing and resistance is coming from. This legislation will provide a single pathway for Australian families to have their family law disputes dealt with within the federal courts. That's our first priority, is the people of this nation that are going through the hurt and pain, not only of a separation from their loved ones and the families and their children, it's the fact is they have to face our family law courts. They are our main priority. And if we can address this system and clean it up and make it easy for them, that is our job. I'm not interested in what the law fraternity want and their comments. It's all about the people in Australia. Under this reform, there will be a single set of rules, procedures, case management, and practices. But as the law currently exists, these changes cannot occur without the agreement of a majority of judges in each court agreeing to respective rules. That's why this bill has been drawn up. Because they can't come to any decision because it may affect them personally. That's why we have to make the decisions on the behalf of the people of this nation. And I turn my, a lot of people in this chamber, and I've explained to you, I've gone through the family law courts as a wife, as a mother, as a grandmother, and I've seen my children go through the pain and anger and what they've had to go through. How many in this chamber have actually experienced that? How many have actually experienced domestic violence? That's a question that we need to ask, people need to know. And to sit here in judgment of people that you have no, you know, you've never worn their shoes. All people tell me all the time, pull me up, is that please do something. I can't see my children. I have, you know, this long system of waiting. You can't get to see your kids or it's under supervision. The pain and anger that people feel, the suicides, the murders of children, filicide. It's always raised about, and I can constantly talk about the fathers out there because they are the forgotten ones in many cases, and it shouldn't be. We talk about filicide, which I've raised. The stats show that filicide is committed by women more than what men are. That's a murder of your children. But no, don't discuss that. These facts need to be open to the public because I will not have any man wrongly accused and pointed at or downtrodden by feminist organisations or people with their own agenda. It's not about the sex, it comes down to the children, it's about the marriage breakups and what's happening, that we have to address all this, wholesome, that we can find the answers to it. This action takes it out of the hands of judges who have been appointed for life and puts it in the hands of the people through their elected representatives, us. In other words, it takes it out of the hands of those who have a vested interest in maintaining the system and retaining extraordinary well-paid jobs for life and puts it in the hands of politicians who remain directly answerable to the electorate. And this restructuring, we are told by the Attorney General, will not lead to a diminishing of specialisation. In fact, in the Federal Circuit Courts, we have about 63 judges. 50 of those judges are specialised. They have an average of 25 years' experience in family law. And a lot of the Federal Circuit Court judges go on to become family law court judges. They hear an extraordinary number of cases a year, not only family law, but migration, civil matters, other matters as well. But in the family law court, they don't have the workload as the others do in the Federal Circuit Court. If you want a decision in the family law courts, you're waiting over 26 months. In the Federal Circuit Court, averages 23 months for a decision to be handed down. No wonder there are so many suicides and depression and problems. And it's not only the parents are going through it, the children are going through it as well because they don't have that contact with their parents. They're denied that right. And the court system, and I've got to say that it was One Nation that brought it to the government's attention over 3 years ago with the Lighthouse Project, which has now been installed into the law system, into the courts. And this is working to help with domestic violence. It was One Nation that actually brought it because I could see the potential that this was a wonderful thing that we have. And it's been utilised now, and I'm pleased to see that. Many other changes that I will be proposing to the committee that I'm deputy chair of, but this needs to happen. We need to merge the two courts. The restructuring has to happen. I can't accept that this restructure will in any way diminish the experience or the expertise of judges involved going forward. The restructuring proposal in the bill is long overdue, and it's intended relief for families before the court is urgently required. I have maintained my efforts to reform the family court for over 20 years, and I am genuinely happy to strongly commend and congratulate the Attorney General for presenting this bill in its current form. It represents a significant step forward, and I confirm that One Nation will be supporting the bill.
Well put, Pauline. And to give us some context and some balance, I just did a rudimentary search on Google, and also on DuckDuckGo, just for a bit of a different platform to see what was being spread about this new bill by the authoritarian left. And funnily enough, I'm so surprised, it's all negative. So the first title is Family Court Merger Condemned by Former Judges and Legal Experts After Legislation Passed. Not much of a surprise from ABC. Family Court Abolished as Controversial Bill Passes Through Senate. Oh, Woman's Agenda. That's a really interesting one. You should read that. It's got a lot of tweets. I guess that's the only place the left communicate anymore. What's the next one? Oh, the New Daily. Legal Experts Fear for Domestic Violence Victims with Family Court Changes. Oh, it's also scary, everybody. Oh, you must be scared. These changes are bad. Oh, and this one from 7 News. Family Court Abolition Bill back in Senate. Ooh. Christian Porter finally abolishes the Family Court of Australia. By the way, good on you, Christian Porter. You disgust me. Jackie Lambie lashes out over government controversial plan. Oh, that's hilarious. Gosh, she's disgusted. That's very, 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 very emotive language. Family court and federal court merger to go ahead. Oof. Standalone family court abolished. Ooh, look at this one. Pedestrian TV. The government just got rid of family court with the help of One Nation and crossbenchers. Oh, and there's something about a moldy house. Anyway, I thought that was very interesting. So this one's DuckDuckGo. Family Court Abolition Bill back in Senate. 7 News, all there as lefty as the rest. Family Court Merger set to pass by. Well, yeah, that seems pretty good. Yeah. Abolition of Family Court, Tasmanian Greens. Or let's have a look. Oh, yeah. Oh, look there. Look at what's written under there. Oh, it's all negative. Look at just the writings. I'm not going to click on these sites because I don't want to give them any attention. But just have a look at the writing underneath. Government's Family Court Abolition will impact vulnerable. Oh, geez, these are funny as hell. You can screenshot these, they're funny. The government has virtually abolished the family court. Oof. Abolishing the family law court risks harm to vulnerable, I'm sure, vulnerable women. Family court abolition will put families at greater... Gosh, wow. So families haven't been at risk already? How can they get at greater risk? My golly. Anyway, I just thought you'd all be very interested in that, and I really, really am quite hopeful for the future. Thank you, Pauline Hanson. You've done a great job.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On any other day, we might care what you say, but every Saturday is Father's Day. You might call it sad, you might call us mad, but we've got one nation. And Pauline Hanson.
Ah, feels good, don't it? Have a great day, guys. Please like, subscribe, or leave a comment. I'd love for some people to leave comments on this one. I love some discourse, so please leave a comment. I'd be happy to jump on board. Anyway, all right, we'll see you next time.